The signal current path is often well known, but the return path is uncertain. Are you sure about the return path? Test yourself in this video. On this PCB, you can see two ICs. The green trace on the top is the signal path where the current is flowing from left to right. But how does the current flow back? Does the current flow directly from right to left? Does the current flow back below the green trace? Or does the current flow back again somehow like this? Okay, this last version is wrong anyway. Let's simplify this problem. The green line at the top again shows the signal path. But at which of the blue paths does the current flow back? Is it 1, 2, 3, or 4? The answer depends on the frequency. At low frequencies, frequencies below 1 kHz, the return current is divided almost equally between all four lines. At high frequencies, frequencies higher than 10 kHz, the return current flows mainly along line 1. The reason for this is that current always chooses the path of lowest impedance. For our return current, this usually means the path with the lowest inductance because the ohmic value is low anyway. And the path with the lowest inductance is usually the one with the smallest loop area. Now back to our initial circuit. We must make our answer dependent on the frequency. For low frequencies, the current return path goes from right to left. The current flow is not just in a single line, but splits over a large area. However, the high frequency return current flows directly next to the green line, although this path is longer. This can become a problem if the path is somehow blocked, because then the electrons would have to take a more difficult route. In such a scenario, it would not be the signal line that causes EMC problems. Instead, a voltage drop across the ground plane would occur, resulting in common mode radiation. So, it's best to just avoid such unnecessary structures.